60 minutes overtime.
This week on 60 Minutes, our story is about Boston Dynamics, which is a cutting-edge robotics company. It was exciting to actually get inside Boston Dynamics. Nicole Marks, the producer, has been working on this for literally for years. To get inside there, you get a little sense like you're peeking behind the curtain.
And, you know, Spot's about 60 pounds.
We interviewed Mark Raybert, who founded the company.
Boston Dynamics started on the set of this 20th Century Fox movie outside of L.A. called Rising Sun. Mm-hmm. And we were providing robots for the background of a scene in the movie.
But only you have the next generation of technology to do this kind of work.
And we were there for a week, and it was a week of hell.
Why was it a week of hell?
Because nothing worked.
You realize you had a lot more work to do.
We had a lot more work to do.
I think for a lot of people, when you see the videos of robots doing these things, I mean, it's clearly extraordinary and amazing.
It's crazy.
And to see it in person, it's really startling. It's almost like it takes a little while for your eyes to adjust to what you're seeing. You know, these are machines, but because they are in animal form or human form, because their motion is so extraordinary, it's hard not to kind of anthropomorphize them. And undeniably, for a lot of people, there's also kind of a fear factor involved. I feel like every person who makes robots in movies always thinks it's going to be for the good. And I mean, I hate to say this, they usually end up getting killed by the robots themselves. You don't worry about that.
I mean, that's the movies. What can I say? You know, I hope people can see outside that because, you know, there's a huge opportunity for the good things robots can do for us. You know, I think robots are going to be our helpers. They're going to keep people from having to go into very dangerous situations. You know, we have a robot at Chernobyl making radiation measurements. I mean, do you want a person doing that? So whereas Hollywood might be focused on the risks, I think the opportunities are huge, and it would be a shame not to take advantage of those opportunities.
That's how you see the future of robots. I mean, it's helpers and working in environments that are not conducive to humans working in, or working alongside humans for productivity.
And in some cases, doing things people can't do because of strength or precision things. Yeah, I think that's what they'll be used for.
It's interesting to actually drive Spot. It's actually very intuitive and very easy. You can just kind of get it going in a certain direction. So you're not really kind of doing much of anything. And that was kind of probably one of the most interesting things about driving the robots.
I think there are three really key pieces in robotics. There is vision, there's mobility, and there's manipulation.
Kevin Blankenspor is one of the lead engineers at Boston Dynamics.
It is interesting to see how difficult it is to get a robot to do even a quarter of all the things a human being can do.
Yeah.
I mean, all the things that we can do that we just take for granted. We don't even think about doing.
Finding a box is so easy for a human, right? You know, you can walk in with no training and tell me where all the boxes are. It takes years of robotics development to actually be able to do that.
Years.
Years. We've been working on all of the pieces, the vision, the manipulation, the mobility for 2 decades. And we're, you know, it's the tip of the iceberg. We're just getting started.
The thing I came away with is just realizing how far, you know, robotics still has to go in order to actually be able to really mirror human movements or animal movements. Some of the engineers have had Spot in their homes due to COVID this past year, and they all say how large it is and how noisy it is in a home setting. Not something you realize kind of in a big workshop or outdoors. So 50 years from now, what's a robot going to look like from that Boston Dynamics puts out?
That's a tough question. There's no doubt that today's robots will look minimum compared to tomorrow's robots. I think the versatility of the robots will be greatly enhanced. I think that the ease of giving them a new task will be greatly enhanced. And, you know, it won't be that long until you can talk to it like you talk to Alexa and tell it what you want it to do. And it will understand more and more about understanding what you have in mind, given the environment it's in.
When you say not too far, what do you mean?
We've done experiments with talking to Spot. I don't think that's far away. I think having it understand complicated situations and what you mean is a little further out. But, you know, in 5 years, you'll see significant progress. And we're working on some designs right now to achieve some of that.